Welcome students, hope you're all doing good. So before we move on to today's class, let us have a small recap of what we learned in the previous class. Okay, so first we looked into what is habitat, and next we moved on to the types of habitat. In types of habitat, we saw the two types. Okay, so what it is? It is the aquatic habitat. And in aquatic habitat, we looked into what is freshwater habitat and marine water habitat. And next, we moved on to the second type of habitat, that is the terrestrial habitat. Okay, so in terrestrial habitat, we saw what is desert habitat, grassland habitat, and the forest habitat. At last, we looked into the plant adaptations and its modifications. Okay. So in today's class, we'll be looking into the fifth unit, that is the living world of animals. Okay, so we'll be looking into what is biodiversity, and next we'll be seeing what is habitat, and then we'll be moving to the unicellular and multicellular organisms. In today's class, we'll be learning only about unicellular organisms. Okay, so in unicellular organisms, we'll be seeing what is amoeba, paramecium, and euglena. So what are we going to discuss in today's class? We'll be looking into biodiversity, the habitat, unicellular organisms. So first we'll be looking into what is biodiversity. In the living world, a lot of diversity is seen both in animals and plants. Every plant and animal is unique. Okay, so the term biodiversity refers to the totality of species, populations, communities, and ecosystems. Okay, it includes both wild and domestic. So biodiversity may also be defined as the variety and variability among living organisms and the habitats in which they live. Okay, so what is biodiversity? It refers to the totality of species, populations, communities, and ecosystems. Okay, it includes both wild and domestic. It may also be defined as the variety and variability of living organisms and the habitats in which they live. So biodiversity includes a variety of ecosystems such as those occur in deserts, forests, mountains, lakes, rivers, and agricultural fields. Okay, in each ecosystem, living creatures including humans form a community interacting with one another and with other animals, plants, air, water, and soil around them. So the living things form the biotic community, and the non-living things forms the abiotic community. Okay, so what is a biotic community? It includes all the living things. Okay, and what is abiotic community? It includes all the non-living things, okay, which are not alive. Okay, so what does biodiversity mean? It includes the variety and variability among living organisms and the habitats in which they live. Okay, it includes a variety of ecosystems such as those occur in deserts, forests, mountains, lakes, rivers, and agricultural fields. So next we'll be moving on to habitat. So already in the previous class, you would have learned in detail about what is habitat. Okay, so each and every organism needs a place to reproduce. So such a dwelling place is called habitat. Okay, so the living or the dwelling place of an organism is called as habitat. So what is habitat? The dwelling or the living place of an organism in which they live and reproduce. Okay, so such places are called as habitat. So the fishes and crabs grow only in water, while many animals like elephants, tigers, and camels live on land. So from this GIFs, you can see that the fishes and crabs grow only in water, whereas many animals like elephants, tigers, camels, they live on land. Okay, the geographical features and environmental conditions on Earth differ from one place to another, though
Camel can live anywhere. It is able to live in deserts more comfortably. Similarly, polar bears and penguins dwell in cold regions. So from this, you can see that camels can live anywhere, but it will be able to live in deserts comfortably. Okay. Likewise, polar bears and penguins dwell comfortably only in colder regions. Okay. From this, what we observe is that the geographical features and environmental conditions on the earth differ from one place to another. Next, we'll move on to the do you know. In Jurong Birds Park, which is situated in Singapore, there the penguins are kept in a big glass case with icebergs and the temperature is maintained at 0 degrees Celsius and below. Okay, so in Jurong Birds Park, the penguins will be kept in a big glass case. Okay, it will be filled with icebergs and its temperature is maintained at 0 degrees Celsius and below. Okay, so since the polar bears and penguins can only dwell in colder regions, the penguins are kept in a big glass case with icebergs and its temperature is maintained at 0 degrees Celsius and below in Jurong Birds Park. Okay.
Next, we'll be looking into what are unicellular and multicellular organisms. Okay. The living things are made up of small units called as the cells. Okay, so these are the gibs of cells. Okay, the cells will be looking like this. So all the functions and processes in the body of living things are brought about with the help of these microscopic cells. So these cells can be visible only under the microscope. Okay, so these cells will be in smaller sizes, that is, it will be very tiny that you can see these cells only with the help of a microscope. Okay, so some organisms are made up of a single cell and these are called as unicellular organisms. For example, amoeba, paramecium and euglena. Okay, so this is the picture of amoeba, this is the picture of paramecium and this is the picture of euglena. Okay, so these type of organisms are made up of only single cell. Okay, that is why they are called as unicellular organisms. So the organisms that are made up of many cells are called as multicellular organisms. Okay, for example, fish, frog, lizard, bird and man are multicellular. Okay, so these are the gifs of fish, frog, lizard, birds and man. Okay, so these organisms are made up of two or many cells. Okay, so these organisms are called as multicellular organisms. Okay, so these are the examples of multicellular organisms. So in today's class, you'll be learning in depth about what are unicellular organisms. Okay, so what are unicellular organisms? So unicellular organisms are organisms that are made up of only single type of cell. Okay, so they are very small, usually microscope. Okay, they cannot be seen with the naked eye. They are mostly aquatic, simplest and most primitive of all animals.
So what are unicellular organisms? They are generally small, microscopic and it cannot be seen under a naked eye. Okay, they are mostly aquatic, simplest and most primitive of all animals. So what does the word primitive mean? It is nothing but the earliest age or period. Okay, it also refers to the characteristics of an early stage of development. Okay, so the unicellular organisms are mostly aquatic, simplest and most primitive of all animals. So the unicellular organisms performs all their physiological activities by the special structures present inside the body called as organelles. Okay, so these are the pictures of organelles. So what are organelles? They are generally present inside the unicellular organisms which performs all their physiological activities. So now you'll be learning about amoeba. Okay, so amoeba is an unicellular organism. So what is a unicellular organism? An organism which contains only single type of cells are called as unicellular organism. Okay, so amoeba is a unicellular organism. It does all the activities like digestion, locomotion, respiration and reproduction. So what are all the activities performed by amoeba? It is digestion, locomotion, respiration and reproduction. Okay, so these are the gifs of amoeba. Okay, so what is an amoeba? It is a unicellular organism and it does all the activities like digestion, locomotion, respiration and reproduction. So what is locomotion? Locomotion is the movement or the ability to move from one place to another. Okay, so what is locomotion? It is the process of moving from one place to another. And what is respiration? It is the process of breathing. Okay, that is the inhaling of oxygen and exhaling of carbon dioxide. Okay, so locomotion is the process or the ability to move from one place to another, and respiration is the inhaling and exhaling. Okay, it is the inhaling of oxygen and exhaling of carbon dioxide. We generally call it as the process of breathing. Okay, so from the GIF you can see that the amoeba is moving from one place to another with the help of the pseudopod. Okay, so the pseudopods are also called as the false food. So with the help of the pseudopods, the amoebas are able to move from one place to another. So it swallows food from the water and the food is digested in the food vacuole. Okay, so from the picture you could see the food vacuole, it is above the purple color, that is, it is above the nucleolus. Okay, so the contractile vacuoles help in excretion. So from the picture you could see that the blue round structure is the contractile vacuole, so it helps in the process of excretion. Okay, excretion is the elimination of the waste. Okay, so the amoeba excretes the waste matters through the contractile vacuoles, and the respiration is by simple diffusion through the body surface. So what is respiration? It is the process of breathing, that is, it is the inhaling of oxygen and the exhaling of carbon dioxide. Okay, and these amoebas have finger-like structures called the pseudopodia, which is also called as false food, helps in the movement or locomotion. Okay, so it helps amoeba to move from one place to another. Got it, students? So the food vacuole swallows the food from the water and the food is being digested. Okay, and the contractile vacuoles helps in the process of excretion. So amoeba has finger-like structures called the pseudopodia or the false food, which helps in the process of locomotion. Okay, students, next we'll move on to the paramecium. So paramecium is also a unicellular organism, that is, paramecium also contains only single type of cell, okay, which lives in water and moves with the help of cilia. So these are the gifs of paramecians. Okay, so from the picture you could see that the paramecium also contains the contractile vacuole and the food vacuole. So the purpose of food vacuole is to collect the food from the water and it helps in the process of digestion. Okay, and the main process of contractile vacuole is excretion, that is, it eliminates the waste. Okay, so you could see the cilia is present all over the body. Okay, so that cilia is helpful in making the paramecium to move from one place to another. Got it, students? Paramecium is also a unicellular organism which lives in water. Okay, so paramecium moves with the help of cilia. So these are the gifs. From this you can see that with the help of the cilia, the paramecium is able to move from one place to another. Okay, so the last one is about euglena. So euglena is also an unicellular animal which moves with the help of a flagellum. Okay, so these are the gifs of euglena. So from the picture you could see that the euglena also has a contractile vacuole which helps in the process of excretion. Okay, and in the top you could see that there is a hair like structure. Okay, so that hair like structure is called as flagellum. Okay, so that flagellum is used in the process of movement, that is, it makes the euglena move from one place to another. Got it, students? So that's it for today's class. Now I'll do a recap of what we learned in today's class, okay? First, we looked into what is biodiversity. So the term biodiversity refers to the totality of species, populations, communities, and ecosystems. It may also be defined as the variety and variability among living organisms and the habitats in which they live, okay? So next, we saw that the biodiversity includes variety of ecosystems such as those occur in deserts, forests, mountains, lakes, rivers, and agricultural fields, okay? So the living things forms the biotic community and the non-living things forms the abiotic community, okay? So next, we moved on to habitat. So each and every organism needs a place to live and reproduce, okay? So such a dwelling place is called as habitat. So what is habitat? The living or dwelling place of an organism is known as habitat. And we saw that the fishes and crabs grow only in water, whereas many animals like elephants, tigers, and camels live on land, okay? And next, we saw that the camels can live anywhere, but it will be able to live in deserts more comfortably, and the polar bears and penguins dwell in colder regions, okay? Next, we saw the do you know? And next, we moved on to the unicellular and multicellular organisms. So we saw that the living things are made up of small units called cells, okay? So the organisms that are made up of single cells are called as unicellular organisms. So what are unicellular organisms? The organisms that are made up of a single cell are called as unicellular organisms. And we saw the example of unicellular organisms that are amoeba, paramecium, and euglena, okay? Next, we moved on to the multicellular organisms. So what are multicellular organisms? The organisms that are made up of many cells are called as multicellular organisms, okay? The examples of multicellular organisms are the fish, frog, lizard, bird, and man. And in today's class, we saw about what are unicellular organisms. So the organisms that are made up of a single cell are called as unicellular organisms. Generally, unicellular organisms are small and microscopic, okay? They cannot be seen under a naked eye. They are mostly aquatic, simplest, and most primitive of all animals. And then we moved on to what are organelles. So organelles are generally present inside the unicellular organisms, which performs all their physiological activities. Okay. Next, we moved on to the amoeba, okay? So amoeba is a unicellular organism and it does all the activities like digestion, locomotion, respiration, and reproduction. We saw what is locomotion. So locomotion is the movement from one place to another, and respiration is the inhaling of oxygen and exhaling of carbon dioxide, okay? And next, we saw that the food vacuoles swallows the food from the water and the food is being digested. The contractile vacuoles help in excretion, and the respiration is performed by simple diffusion through the body surface, okay? So the amoeba has finger-like structures called the pseudopodia or the false foot, which helps in movement or locomotion. Next, we moved on to the paramecium. So paramecium is also an unicellular organism which lives in water and moves with the help of cilia, okay? We saw the gifts of paramecium. And at last, we looked into what is euglena. So euglena is also a unicellular organism which moves with the help of flagellum, okay? So that's it, students. I have attached the assignments for you. Kindly write it in your rough notebook, okay? Thank you, students.